Sometimes it's very misleading when we look at the midline deviation from the center line. In this case, it looks like the midline is deviated only 1 or 2 millimeters, and it will be an easy correction. However, when you look at this side view, you can see that the molars are fully class 2 on one side, fully class 1 on the other side, or almost class 1, I should say. But the most compelling view is looking at the view from the occlusal, and you can see that the midline has to translate a lot. And one way to do this, to better appreciate the amount of correction, is to look at what needs to be done in the posterior area. In order to obtain the correction, we have to distalize the molars into a class 1 occlusion. And then select the upper anterior teeth, assuming that, again, it's only the upper anteriors, could also and probably involve the lowest too. But for the sake of discussion today, and then what we need to do is to get these teeth to move all the way here.